Let me start by thanking the organizers for inviting me to come here and celebrate Mike's career so far. And I emphasize so far because I'm sure you have lots of exciting things in your future, in whatever you choose to do. So I'm looking forward to those. So before I go into the technical talk, I'll just give a couple of remarks of kind of what is my connection in the past with Mike. So I was a graduate student at Rutgers from 95 to 98. But actually, I owe going to Rutgers to Steve Weinberg. So I finished my undergraduate degree in Austin, Texas. And I had a foray as an experimentalist. I actually designed and built a laser. And I realized that stuff was not for me. I mean, even though actually that laser worked, and whenever I went back to Austin to give a seminar, the molecular spectroscopy laptop in which I built it was using it to do experiments. So it actually worked, which is actually super surprising because at home I'm not able to screw anything, like to do anything manual. But the other thing I also did is that I was very lucky that there was a professor in the math department that gave me like a little project on a renormalization group in the statistical mechanics models. And then I realized that this is what I really wanted to do. So I went to talk to Professor Weinberg. He was very generous and he told me, well, for the kind of thing you want to do, you should check out Rutgers. Of course, I had never heard of Rutgers. I didn't know where it was or anything like that. But I took him very seriously. By the way, he made a prediction that which turned out to be true, like many of his predictions. He said, you should go to Rutgers, but I don't know how long that place will last. And I guess he knew something that, and he was right. I mean, it kind of disintegrated in some sense. Well, it's still there, by the way, but. So I'm probably, how do you use the laser? Yeah, so I probably remember with rosy glasses because I was young. That's the period also I met my Sheila, which is my wife, and you know, you remember these things very romantically. But it really was a magical place at that time. I mean, in particular, the thing I remember very vividly is that like the group meetings and the lunches were really fantastic. I mean, I learned more from those lunches than anywhere else in the world. And it was really, the group was fantastic. I mean, I think you know most of the people that were there. I mean, some of the projects that we had at the time, some of them were like people like Shamit, Juan Maldacena, you know, Eva Silverstein. These are pretty impressive people. So as a student, it was like amazing just to be there. Even though I have to say that, I guess because of my past as an experimentalist, when I came to Rutgers, I guess they were trying to me to still do to become an experimentalist. So they put me in TP. I remember those horrible things outside. So this is like some trailers outside the physics department, which had holes. And I remember being in my office with a jacket because you were freezing in there. But somehow eventually, and that I owe to Steve Schenker, he somehow promoted me from the trailer to coming what was called in a very pompous name, the String Palace. So I was promoted to String Palace and then I kind of joined the group. So even though as a student, actually, I mostly wrote papers by myself and other fellow students. I had the great pleasure to write one paper with Mike. And we wrote this paper called Fractional Brains and Broad Brains, which the premise was to try to give a geometric interpretation to certain deep brain states as described by a conformal field theory in the geometric regime. Okay, and that was a lot of fun. I remember we had a lot of fun doing this. One thing that I remember vividly with Mike, and I guess is also emphasized by Nat yesterday, is that he was really very brilliant. And sometimes with the students, we would discuss with him. Sometimes we didn't understand what you were really saying. Sometimes it was because the physics was too deep for us. Sometimes because we really couldn't understand you, like the voice. It was very soft. But I remember it as a great pleasure. And then at some point, we kind of continued in parallel because the question was how to generalize this idea that we did for LE spaces to Calabi-Yau threefolds, which was a much more challenging problem because there is the issue that as you move in the moduli space of your Calabi-Yau, you can have lines of marginal stability and so on. So then there were two papers. One is more famous than the other one, of course,